If you cannot speak about them, يقول محمد بن يونس ما رأيت للقلب أنفع من ذكر الصالحين. I have not seen anything more beneficial to the heart than to remember those who have salah in their heart. And thirdly, we have to remember that we are strangers in this dunya. We are strangers in a strange world. كن غريب كن في الدنيا كأنك غريب غريب أو عابر سبيل. Be in this dunya as a total stranger. Or someone who's passing through a path as a journeyman who sits under the oasis. And then, before you know, he's gone. That fleeting moment of his passage is your life. This is the ghurba in which we have to remember. We remember that this lust and desire and thoughts are not going to last. And you have to be in control of what's in your heart. Remember how we will grow old and lose our youthful luster. Our youth luster. We will lose our hair, our teeth, our hair will become gray. Imam Ahmad used to look at himself in the mirror, and he would say, how did this come about? He saw a few gray hairs, and all of a sudden, he was a man with gray hairs. How did this come about? In no time, your life will be done. وَمَنْ نُعَمِّرْهُ نُنَكِّسْهُ فِي الْخَلْقِ And whoever lives, whoever has a chance to live in his life, he will be brought down and deteriorated in his physical composition. If we live long enough, this is what we will see. And remember, sakaratul maut. Remember that you will die and that there will be something called the pangs of death. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself used to pray to Allah to protect him from the pangs of death. Ya Allah, forget the word of the Prophet. Hawwin ala Muhammadin sakaratul maut. And he would say, Ya Allah, make easy the pangs of death on Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And remember that you will be asked. You will be asked when you will be raised on the Day of Judgment. And you will be asked everything, even the fetus who was aborted from the womb of her mother, who has done no sin, who has earned no life. وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ بِأَيَّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ Even she will be asked, that fetus, what have you done? What sin have you done? Everybody will be asked for every minute of our lives. Every thought, everything, every single actions that we have done will be tested and asked on the Day of Judgment. So remember that you will be facing Allah in the presence of all these creations. And you will be defamed and disgraced for the things that you've done if you are going to be shown your sins in front of these people. But Allah will help the person according to his niyyah. As the Prophet rahmatullahi alayhi would say, إذا أن الله يعين العبد على قدر نيته ويفتح له على قدر همته وإنما على العبد الأسباب وعلى الله فتح الأبواب. So he tells us this beautiful wisdom that if you have the intentions to better yourself, that Allah will help you according to your intentions, and Allah will help the person according to his intention, and he will open for him all these great victories. And all that we need to do is to move on to the path and to get on to the path, and Allah will open the ways to that salvation which we seek. So the first thing that we do in seeking this path of salvation is that we prepare our environment. To prepare our environment, the first thing that we need to do is to try and spend certain moments on our own. To try and spend certain moments just thinking about ourselves, even if we are not thinking, even if we are not reflecting, just be alone on yourself. How many times have we heard this in the khutbah, in the lessons, in the advices of the scholars, but we are not taking heed. So to think about what you've done during the day, at least be alone for certain moments. But he says, even if you're not thinking. And to visit the grave, زيارة القبور وإن بلا فكر. To visit the grave, even if you don't have any thought. I remember this person when I lived in Medina, a cab driver, someone who looked pious, a person with a beard. And when I got in his cab, he complained to me. He says, Ya Akhi, what do you do about a heart which is qasi? It is so hard, I don't weep. When I see the dead, I'm all afraid. When I go to salah, I don't feel the presence of Allah. What's wrong with me? I told him, go to the qubur. He says, I went to the qubur. Nothing is happening to me. People are dying left and right, but nothing. I don't feel anything. His heart is hard. But what is the solution? The the rest to Allah. And he tells us, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in one of the narrations, كُنْتُ نَهَيْتُكُمْ عَنْ زِيَارَةِ الْقُبُورِ فَزُرُوهَا فَإِنَّهَا تُذَكِّرُ الْمَوْتِ وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ زُرُوا الْمَقَابِرَ فَإِنَّهَا تُذَكِّرُ الْآخِرَةِ فَإِنَّهَا تُذَكِّرُ visit the graves, for it reminds you of the hereafter. And he tells us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَكْثِرُوا مِنْ ذِكْرِ الْمَوْتِ فَإِنَّهُ هَادِمٌ لِلْدَّاتِ. Remember death often, because this will suppress your lust and your desires. And then he says, نُزُومُ الْإِسْتِغْفَارِ وَإِنْ بِلَا حُدُودِ. Say, astaghfirullah all the time. Astaghfirullah as much as you can, even if your heart is not with it. Just say it. Keep on saying it. Allah is truthful when he says, استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمددكم بأموال وبنين واجعل لكم جنات واجعل لكم أنهار. He tells us these things and there are promises. Those who say استغفار, Allah will يرسل السماء, he will shower you with his rain, and he will يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمددكم بأموال, and he will bless you with children and progeny, and he will bless you with gardens and rivers. And he also says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, istaghfirullah wa atubu ilayhi yumditkum wa atubu ilayhi yumatta'akum mata'an hasanan ila ajalin musamma. This is the promise of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The person who makes istighfar and turns to Allah in repentance, Allah will prolong his life. His life will be long, but with what? Yumatta'akum mata'an hasanan. حَسَنًا إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. A long life of pleasure and enjoyment, but in the obedience of Allah. سُئِلَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَيُّ النَّاسِ خَيْرٌ قَالَ مَنْ قَالَ عُمْرُهُ وَحَسُنَ عَمَلُهُ. Who is the best of the people? Is the one whose life has been prolonged. A long life, but his deeds are excellent. This is what happens when you make istighfar, even if you don't see the results. And Hud alayhi salam, when he speaks to his people, and he tells them to make istighfar, he tells them, يَجِدْكُمْ قُوَّةً إِلَّا قُوَّتِكُمْ. All these promises. But most importantly, for the person who lives in a heart which is constricted with the suffering of ma'asi, the Prophet tells us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَنْ لَزِمَ الْإِسْتِغْفَارَ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ مِنْ كُلِّ هَمٍّ فَرَجًا وَمِنْ كُلِّ ضَيْقٍ مَخْرَجًا وَرَزَقَهُ اللَّهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. This is what this person seeks, is a peace of mind, and his heart becomes expanded from this constriction of ma'asi. Who is regular with istighfar, Allah will make a way out from all his troubles, and he makes a way out from his constriction, and he will bless him with from where he does not even know. So he says, "Duzumul istighfari wa in bila hudud." To remain on this path of regular istighfar, to ask Allah istighfar, even if the heart is not there, and even if you see no results. And then, as-salatu ala al-Nabi. Was-salatu ala al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fi jami'i al-umur. Yaqulu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Man salla alayhi salatan sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who prays for me, who sends his peace and blessings on me, once Allah will send his peace and blessings on you. And his peace and blessings, as-salatu of Allah, is when he remembers you in the presence of his angels. I'm going to tell you this. If one salatu ala al-Nabi is accepted, your life is done. You're made up. You're made up for Jannah. Imagine if Allah sends his peace and blessings only once. Man salla alayhi salatan, salla Allahu alayhi ashra. Sallu ala al-Nabi. This is such a powerful thing that he gives us as an instruction. And here, I will pause. This is the advice from Sheikh Al-Zarruq. And I'm saying these are the inspirations of his words, because it is not word by word. So after saying these things, he says, after hearing all of this, and if the person continues in his path of ma'asi, and he does not do the things which we've told him, to remember Allah and the last day and his sakarat al-mawt, and to make istighfar and salatu ala al-nabi and so forth, he says, this is ghaba'un wa khudlan. This is self-deceit and madness. It is stupidity. It is sheer madness and self-deceit.